Hey everyone, welcome to the third episode of the Biotomonal Classroom with RDuPi. So in this episode, I will teach you how to use the inbuilt microphone on the Bioterminal and build a simple decibel meter to detect the sound levels in the environment. So without further ado, let's jump straight into the video. At first, let's look at what a microphone is. Normally, when we use microphones with Arduino, we use electret microphones and they are able to capture or respond to sound vibrations from every angle. So when these microphones capture sound vibrations, they convert these sound vibrations into electrical pulses. And later, these electrical pulses can be amplified over a speaker to achieve much louder sounds. These microphones communicate with an Arduino using the analog interface. So this is the Grove analog microphone, and if you want to learn more about other Grove modules, you can visit the Grove homepage and learn more about different Grove modules offered in the Grove family. So these Grove modules are categorized into different categories, so you can choose your Grove module which is suitable for your application. The Bioterminal has a built-in microphone, and if you look at the front of the Bioterminal, underneath this enclosure, you can find a microphone soldered onto the PCB. So these are some of the specifications of the microphone that is used inside the Bioterminal. So now let's go ahead and test this microphone. So first, connect the Bioterminal to the PC and turn it on. After that, open File Explorer and you will find a drive named RDuPi. And go into that drive and you will find a file named main.py. So open this file. And now we will start writing our codes inside the Microsoft Visual Studio Code. So I have explained to you before how to install and set up Microsoft Visual Studio Code on your computer. So if you don't want to use Microsoft Visual Studio Code, you can also use Notepad to write your codes. So first, let's include some functions from the machine module. So here we have included the ADC, pin and map functions from the machine module. After that, let's include the time module. After that, we need to read the values output from the microphone. As I have explained to you before, a microphone communicates with a microcontroller using the analog interface. So normally when microphones detect sound vibrations, they send these vibrations to a microcontroller via analog signals. A microcontroller cannot process analog signals, so most of the microcontrollers have an inbuilt ADC, which is an analog to digital converter. So the Bioterminal also has an analog to digital converter, which converts the analog signals coming out from the microphone to digital signals. So the Bioterminal has a 10-bit analog to digital converter, so that means it can have 2 to the power 10, which is equal to 1024 ADC values. So the ADC value range can be from 0 to 1023. So when the mic detects the loudest sound, the ADC value will be 1023, and when it detects the lowest sound, it will be 0. So when you want to use the ADC on the Bioterminal, you need to make sure to connect the analog sensors to the analog pins on the Bioterminal. But in this case, we are using the inbuilt microphone on the Bioterminal, so you don't have to make any connections here. So what you need to do is you need to write this line of code to create ADC on the mic pin. So I have explained to you before about the map function, and this VIO mic is inside this map function. So you can call it as map.VIO mic to access the built-in microphone. And once you access the microphone, you can read the ADC values from the microphone by using ADC.read command. So ADC.read command is similar to the analog read command that you use in Arduino to read ADC values from analog sensors. So let's go back to our main.py file and create the ADC on the built-in mic pin. After that, type while true, which is a while loop, and to read the ADC values, assign a variable called adcval and equal to adc.read. after that, print the ADC values. And finally, add a delay. Now, in order to visualize these ADC values, we need to open Putty. And I will change this appearance to 16. And we need to connect to the wire terminal via serial communication. So COM4 is the port that this wire terminal is connected to the PC, and this is the baud rate, and open it. After that, go to File and save it, and you will see the ADC values get printed here. So when I expose this mic to noise, you will see that the ADC values are not constant, but they are changing fast. I will show you this on the serial plotter as well to explain you further. So we will be using the serial plotter on the Arduino IDE. So if you have Arduino IDE, you can skip this step. But if you don't have Arduino IDE, you can go to this website, arduino.cc, and go to software and select downloads. And select the relevant installer based on your operating system. So here I will select Windows installer because I'm on a Windows computer. And select just download. So wait a few seconds until the download is finished. After that, install by following the installation wizard. Now open Arduino. Then go to Tools, Port, and select COM4, because in my case, this wire terminal is connected to COM4 on the computer. And select Tools again and select Serial Plotter. And then go to this file and save it again. And you'll see the ADC values get displayed as a graph. So now I will play back again the same sound I played before. So as you can see, there's a lot of noise in this signal. So what we need to do is we need to smooth this signal out by removing this noise. So to do that, we need to use a moving average filter. So a moving average filter is a basic technique that can be used to remove noise from a signal and smooth it out. So it is a simplified form of a low pass filter, and running a signal through this filter will remove high frequency information from the output. So the moving average filter takes the average of the last m amount of entries in the signal and averages them to produce the output. This can be called as the window size, and the parameter can be changed according to your needs. But you need to keep in mind, if the window size is too small, the signal may still end up being very noisy. And if the window size is very large, some critical information in the signal may be lost, because the filtered signal will lag behind the raw signal. So you have to go through a trial and error process to choose the appropriate window size for your application. So now let's go back to the main.py file, and we will keep these three lines and delete this part. And let's assign a window size n equal to 50. Now let's define some variables and set them to 0. After that, create a function and let's make these variables as global variables. After that, type this. So this is to remove the oldest entry from the sum. After that, assign the value variable to ADC values. Then type this. This is to add the newest reading to the window. Then type this. This is to add the newest reading to the sum. After that, type this. Then type this equation. So that's the equation for the result. Now let's print out the raw ADC values and the values that we get after the moving average filter. So let's print the ADC values first. So value, and then let's type n equals two inverted commas with a space. So what this will do is, this will print the next value after this value. So I will type average. So this raw ADC value will be printed first, and the average value after the filter will be printed to the right of the raw value. After that, let's add a delay of 100 milliseconds. So this checks whether this is run from the main.py file. After that, let's add a while loop and execute the main function. Now I have opened Putty here, so let's save this file, and we will see that these are the raw ADC values and these are the filtered values. So you can see these values are constant, they are not changing as much as the raw ADC values. So let's play the noise first as before. So now you can see the ADC values, the filtered ADC values are not changing as much as before. Now I will show this on the serial plotter as well. So select COM4, tools, serial plotter, save this file. And now let's play the noise like before. So as you can see, the red color line is the filtered line. It's much smoother than the blue color ADC lines. So now that we know how to obtain smooth values out of the raw ADC values, let's understand how sound is measured. Because what we need is, we need a unit to measure the sound intensity. So normally a sound is measured in decibels and the unit is dB. So a whisper is around 30 decibels, a normal conversation is around 60 decibels, and a motorcycle engine running is about 95 decibels. So you need to keep in mind that noise above 70 decibels over a prolonged period of time may start to damage your hearing, and loud noise above 120 decibels can cause immediate harm to your ears. So now it's time to convert the average values into decibel values, because decibel values are more meaningful than only displaying the average values. So to do that, we need to calibrate the average ADC values so that they correspond to decibel values. First, we need to download an application on the mobile phone to detect the decibel values. So if you're on Android, you can download this application called Sound Meter. And if you are on iOS, you can download this application. So now what you need to do is, you need to expose the microphone on the wire terminal to different sound levels and check the mobile phone application as well, how many decibels it shows for different sound levels. And you can draw this table by taking the average ADC values and the corresponding decibel values shown on the mobile phone. So after you obtain these values, the corresponding decibel values are not linear with the average ADC values. So what we need to do is, we need to use a method called linear regression method to get the closest possible linear line. So in Microsoft Excel, go to File, Options, and go to Add-ins, and select Excel Add-ins, and click this, Go, and select Analysis Toolpack, and click OK. After that, go to Data tab, and select this Data Analysis, and check for Regression. This one, regression, select OK. And for input range Y, select this column to this range. And for X range, select this column to this. After that, click labels, select new worksheet, and check this residuals, and click OK. So what we need from this data is this value and this value. So from these numbers, you can write an equation. So the equation of a straight line will be y equals mx plus c, where this is the gradient and this is the intercept at y-axis. So here the y-axis will be the ADC values. So ADC equals, and this is the gradient, 3.19. So 3.19 times x-axis is dB plus c is intercepts, so this one 425.77. let's round it off. And if you take dB from here, the dB will be ADC minus 425.77 divided by 3.19. So this is the equation to get the decibel values. So we will use this equation later in this video. Now we will try to build this simple demo of displaying the decibel readings from the microphone on an analog style meter. So here the needle will move when the decibel values are changing, and here the decibel value will be shown. So now let's go back to our main.py file, and we will make some changes to this code in order to display this on the Vio Terminal LCD screen. So here we will keep all this and change this function to digital meter. After that we will add a variable here, dB, and equal to 0, and make this dB as a global variable here, and delete this and write this equation here. So dB equals, so this ADC will be average here. So after setting these variables, let's add the TFT LCD initialization. Then set the screen rotation. And then initialize a buffer. And finally, create the buffer. I'm sorry, here should be rotation. Then type the following codes. After that, let's create a new function called analog meter. Let's fill this screen in yellow color. And set this meter box in white color. Then let's draw a borderline in black color. So for that, let's copy this. Just paste it. Change this to draw, change this to black. Then let's set the text color. After that, we will draw small ticks every 5 degrees from minus 50 degrees to 50 degrees. So this 20 is the long scale tick length, and there will be a short scale tick as well. I will write it later in this code. So next will be the coordinates of the ticks to draw. So next will be the coordinates of the next tick to fill this zone. So let's copy this and paste it here and make some changes. Next, let's draw for the green color zone. Then let's draw for the yellow color zone. Finally, let's draw for the red color zone. I'm sorry, here should be greater than or equal to. After that, specify the short scale tick length. So here it means if I is divided by 25 and if the remainder is not equal to 0, then the tick length is 8. So that means this tick length is not for this long tick length because they are multiples of 25. See 25, 50, 75 and 100. And for the ones which are not multiples of 25, the tick length is set to 8, which is the short scale tick length. Now let's recalculate the coordinates for the tick length. After that, let's draw the ticks. Then let's find these positions for the labels. After that, let's draw these labels as numbers. I'm sorry, this should be draw center string. After that, we will move to this function, the digital meter function. And here we will display these dB values here on the LCD screen. So to do that, let's type. So here actually we have created the buffer over here. The spr.create sprite, we created the buffer and that will be filled here with yellow color. After that, let's set the text color. Then let's set the text size. Next, we will draw this float. So this will be a float I'm sorry, here should be SPR. So this will display these dB values. Then let's draw a string. Finally, we will push it to the LCD. After that, add a delay of 25 milliseconds. After that, let's create a function to map ADC values from 0 to 100. So we will use that later in this code. After that, let's create another function to move this needle. And what we will do is, we will copy this from here to here and paste it here. Because we will be using the same method to obtain the decibel value and then map it to the needle here. And now we will write some conditions here. So this is to make sure that the needle doesn't go beyond 0 and beyond 100. So it will always stay between 0 and 100. Next, let's add a delay here. Then we will assign some global variables. And let's set the text color as black. Now let's type so this function we have defined before, the map to function. So what this will do is, this will map the ADC values from 0 to 100 to these angles, minus 140 to minus 40 from here to here. Next, let's calculate the tip of needle coordinates. I'm sorry, here should be map dB values to angle, because this is dB. After that, calculate the X delta of needle start. Then let's erase the old needle image. After that, replot text under the needle. So set the color first. And draw the string. DB, so that is this string. Then let's store new needle in coordinates for next erase. After that, let's draw the needle in the new position. So let's copy this from here, the same, and paste it here. We just need to change the color. Here is red. Here we do magenta. And here again we do red. After that, let's create a new function called initial and type the analog meter function and write a millisecond counter. After that, write another function called main and make the update time global. And type this. So this will update every 35 milliseconds. After that, write the function plot needle and write the function digital meter. Here, after this check, we will type initial. So that's the initial function. This function will run at first, and then this while loop will execute on the main function. I'm sorry, I forgot to add the LCD and the sprite function, and here I forgot to add the map module. So I will add them now. So type LCD and sprite. So these are the functions inside the machine module, and here I will add math, which is the math module. One last mistake, I'm really sorry, and that is, if you go into the plot needle function, inside there, if you go down under here, this TX, this should be 0.01745329.25. So now let's go ahead and save this file. So that's it for this video. If you guys like this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay updated with us. So, see you guys in the next video.